Now, band theory of solids. This band theory of solids gives the explanation about conductors, semiconductors and insulators. So to understand the band theory, I'm going into solid structure. What is solids are? In solids, atoms are arranged very close to each other. Here I'm taking a solid material. It is a solid, for example. In this solid, atoms are very close like this. Atoms are very close to each other. Then what happens are here? Interlocking of atoms takes place. Interlocking of atoms takes place. Very, very close to each other. Very close to each other. So if interlocking of atoms takes place, what happens? We have to check here. What happens? Simple. If interlocking of atom takes place, that gives a energy band. That gives a energy band. What is energy band? Simple, sir. Energy band means, here I am taking two atoms for understanding. Two atoms I am taking. It is a one atom. Atom consists a nucleus at the center and surrounded by orbitals. Orbital number 1, orbital number 2, orbital number 3, like that. So many orbitals are there. I am taking orbital number 4 also. Number of orbitals are there. Electrons are present in a orbitals. Electrons are revolving in these orbitals. Like this, some more electrons are revolving in these orbitals. So these are the electrons. If you observe here, what is this? Are this is a lost orbital in this atom. This lost orbital name is a valency orbital. Valency orbital. Lost orbital name is called valency orbital. These electrons are called valency electrons because these are present in a valency band. Here I am taking one more atom. That atom also consists a nucleus at the center. Here nucleus, it is the first orbital. It is a second orbital and its one is a third orbital. And the next take this one as a fourth orbital. I'm taking one more orbital. It is a one more orbital. Again, this atom also consists of what, sir? Consists of electrons. These are the electrons. Electrons present in orbitals and revolves around the nucleus like this. Here, where is valency orbital, sir? This is a valency orbital. These two atoms interlocking takes place. Now, if you observe here, what happening? If you observe here, the energy levels are overlapping to each other. Energy levels are overlapping to each other. If energy levels are overlaps, what happens? That gives a energy band. I already told you. What is energy band? Energy band is a group of energy levels. If you take here, here some group of energy levels are there. We can extend the structure throughout the solid. See, we can extend the structure. It is a band. It is a band that consists of what? That consists of large number of energy levels. Then what is energy band, sir? Large number of energy levels. Large number of energy levels is called a energy band. Is called a energy band. So this energy band gives the answer. For what question, sir? This energy band explains which one is a conductor, which one is a semiconductor, and which one is a insulator. So for conductors, how this energy band exists? Now I'm going to drawing. So band here, what is energy band, sir? You should remember, energy band is very, very important. Large number of energy levels. You take here, atoms in a solid are overlapping. Atoms means what? The valency orbitals also overlapping. So this overlapping gives the information about conductors, semiconductors and insulators.